नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो 9 चैप्टर 15 बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम वर्स नंबर 1। सो इन द लास्ट चैप्टर वी स्टडीड अबाउट किंग पुरुरवा एंड उर्वशी, दैट वाज डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ सोमा डायनेस्टी, हाउ Soma is born to Atri, who is son of Brahma, and then Soma took away the wife of his guru, Brihaspati, Tara. Then Buddha was born, and Buddha met Ila, who was King Sudumna, and gave birth to Pururava. And Pururava met Urvashi and gave birth to 6 sons. So it is quite complex plot, not easy. It's not easy to remember what is going on. Okay. And Sudumna was in Sun dynasty, but then he became Ila. So now he is going to describe the dynasty coming from Pururava. There is primarily description of the dynasties here, but in between some interesting story comes, then he tells that. There is just a list of names. सो इसेज ऐलस्य च उर्वशी गर्भात् सडासन्न आत्मजा नृप आयुः श्रुतायुः सत्यायु रयोथ विजयो जयः। सो फ्रॉम ऐला, ही इज कॉल्ड ऐला बिकॉज ही इज सन ऑफ इला, लाइक अर्जुन इज कॉल्ड पार्थ बिकॉज ही इज सन ऑफ पृथ। सो फ्रॉम द वूम्ब ऑफ उर्वशी he got 6 sons, O king, and they are known as Ayu, Shrutayu, Satyayu, Raya, Vijaya and Jaya. So the first 5, they were born on earth, and 6th one is when she has left. सो श्रुतियोर वसुमान पुत्र सत्यायोश्च श्रुतंजय रयस्य सुत एकस्य जयस्य तनुयो मितः। द सन ऑफ, सो ही इज नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट आयु बिकॉज आयु स्टोरी ही विल टेल लेटर ऑन इन लिटिल मोर डिटेल। फर्स्ट ही वॉन्ट्स टू फिनिश द अदर 5। सो देर इज सूची कटाह न्याय इन संस्कृत, नीडल एंड कॉल्ड्रॉन प्रिंसिपल। इफ यू हैव टू मेक नीडल एंड ए बिग पॉट, देन मेक द नीडल फर्स्ट एंड देन यू कैन डू द अदर थिंग। सो ही इज ट्राइंग टू डू द स्मॉलर वंस फर्स्ट एंड देन ही विल डू द बिगर स्टोरी लेटर। सो देयरफॉर ही drops Ayu, starts from Shrutayu. Shrutayu's son's name was Vasuman, and Satyayu's son's name was Shrutanjaya, Raya was Eka, and Jaya's son was Amita, and Bhima was the son of Vijaya, and Bhima's son was Kanchan, Kanchan's son was Eka, no Hotraka, Kanchano Hotraka, and Tatahastasya Jannu Suto, and his son was Jannu. Gangam Gandu Shikritya Yo Apibat. And this Jannu, he drank the whole Ganga in one sip. So that's why Ganga is also called Janvi. Right? You heard the word Janvi. Janvi is also wife of Lord Nityananda. So Janvi Mata. So it is a name of Ganga. So why it happened is that, you know the story of King Sagar. Sagar had 60,000 sons and he was doing Ashwamedh Yajna. And his horse was stolen by Indra. Indra is a good thief. He's always stealing horses from Prithu, from him. And he tied it in the ashram of Kapila Muni. And then his sons, they were searching for it, because without the horse you cannot complete the yajna. So they found it. And then mistakenly they thought that this Kapila has done this. So they went and they started abusing him. And Kapila was in his meditation. So he opened his eyes and they all got burned to death. 60,000 of them, one shot. So Sagara was waiting, no horse, no children. Then he had a son, I think Anshuman. So he went in search and they came to know that they are dead. Then he wanted to deliver them, so he was told he had to bring Ganga. Ganga was not on earth yet. So he performed tapasya to bring Ganga down on earth. But he was not successful. Then his son was Dilip. Then he also did tapasya. He was also not successful. His son was Bhagirath. So he did tapasya and Ganga appeared to him. So the Ganga Devi asked him, what do you want? And he says, I want that you come on earth. So she agreed. But she said that I need somebody who can uphold me, otherwise I will go to America. I will come with such a force, I'll make a hole in the earth and I'll come to the other side. So if you want that I stay in India, then you have to have someone who can stop me. So he said, well, I can ask Shiva. So then he did tapasya to please Shiva. And Shiva appeared and he says, please, can you help me to hold Ganga? So he said, all right. So then Ganga came dancing and very proud. She was a young lady, full of youth. She thought, who is this Shiva? How he can hold me? So she was being very proud. So Shiva said, Ganga is also called daughter of Himalaya, Girija, because she also comes. Shiva's wife is also daughter of Himalaya. So therefore, there is some relationship. In India, this relationship is considered as jovial relationship. Right? So she thought, I will make some jokes with Shiva. And Shiva was bola. Simple. But when he understood that she is playing tricks on me, so he said, okay. So Ganga came and fell on its head and it got lost in his matted hair. And did not come out, because Ganga was thinking, I'm so great, I'm this, I'm that. She could not get out from the matted hair of Shiva. But now problem is for Bhagirath, who did so much tapasya to get her down on earth and he pleased Shiva, but now problem happened here. And he was waiting, few years passed and Ganga did not come out. Because Shiva says, well, you want to have fun with me, have fun on my head. Or you can say that Shiva is a devotee of Lord Krishna or Lord Vishnu and this is the Charanamrita. So he doesn't want to drop it from his head. He wants to keep it on his head. So then again Bhagirath has to pray to him that please release at least one stream. So then he opened his dreadlock and one stream came out. And then Ganga asked that you please show me where do you want to take me. So he says, okay, I will walk in front of you and you come behind me. He says, no, you have to get some fast vehicle because I'm going to move fast. So he was on his chariot. He says, okay, I will be on the chariot and you follow me. So Bhagirath started in his chariot and he was taking him to Ganga Sagar. This goes through Bengal. Now also they have a big festival in Magh there. So Magh Mela, that's where Ganga enters into the sea or ocean or Arabian. It is called, West Bengal, Bay of Bengal. I don't know how they make these distinctions, which one is Indian and which one is Bay of Bengal. So anyway, she went there. But what happened that on the way, this Jannu was doing his yajna. And he was also a powerful king. He was son of Hotraka. So Hotra means, you know what Hotra means? One who does yajna.
Yeah, Agnihotra. Agnihotra comes from that?
Yes. So he is son of that. So he must be doing yajna himself. So he was making some elaborate arrangements to do yajna. And obviously Bhagirath was not passing by through that. He knew that he didn't want to disturb. But Ganga was being very playful. So she said, let me see what this guy is doing. So she went and swept away all the material of Jannu. Whatever arrangements were being made, she just came with a big flaw and took it away. So when Jannu saw this, he got upset. He says, what is this? Who is this girl? Who has disturbed my yajna? So he took the water in his palm and he drank it. And now there was no more Ganga. Ganga was finished and Bhagirath turned back and everything is empty. And he said, what happened? This whole river has disappeared. So he was very surprised. So he got off his chariot, he came to Jannu and he says, excuse me, sir. He says, yes, did you see one young girl here? He says, what one young girl? He says, one watery girl. He says, yes, he was very, very frivolous. So he says, where did she go? He says, well, she went inside me. So he explained what happened. So then now he has to beg him. He says, please, I did so much tapasya to get her down and then did tapasya to please Shiva and again to please him and now my job is not done. I have to take her to and deliver my ancestors. So then he says, okay, now if I release her from down, then she will be impure. So in Hindi there is a saying, Put ka moot prayag ko pani. Have you heard this? That small children, see now children have different, they have all this. What do they wear this?
Diapers.
In the olden days there was no such thing. So the children will pass urine, you have them in your lap and they pass urine. So there is a saying is that Poot ka moot, prayag ko pani. So prayag is prayag, you know, Allahabad, and pani means water, means this is Ganga water, the urine of the baby. So the urine of the baby is Ganga water, but not of a grown-up man. So he says, well, this will be a big problem. So he says, okay, I bring her out from my ear. So by his yogic power, you have seen yogis, they drink water from their nose and they bring it out from the mouth. That is called neti, right? Jal neti. But you have not heard karna neti. So this karna neti is not every yogi can do that. So he did karna neti. Or rather actually neti, probably not a proper word. He did jal karni. So he had drank through the mouth, but he got it from the ear. And since then, she got the name Janavi, and he accepted her as his daughter. So Janavi means the daughter of King Jannu. So that's what is being referred to here. The story is there in Ramayana, in detail also in Mahabharata. Here he just mentions it. Satasya Jannu Suto Gangam Gandushi Kritya Yopibat. So he has drank. Gandush means one sip. He made one sip. So first what he did, that he was a great yogi also, that he turned the whole Ganga river into one sip of water on his palm. Otherwise river is a continuous stream. How much are you going to drink? The water will keep coming. So he stopped the stream and turned the whole thing into just one gulp of water and drank it. So Govindaya Namo Nama. But then he brought it out. So that's how we have Janavi. Janno stu purus tatputro balakascha atmajo ajakah. And the son of Jannu is Puru, and Puru's son is Balaka, and Balaka's son is Ajaka. Okay. So let's see the commentary, there is hardly anything here. So Ailvansha Bhuvo Gadher Dohitratmaja Ishwaraha Arjunam Dhenu Hartaram Ramah Panchadasho Vadhit. So he says that in this 15th chapter, this is the summary of the chapter, the dynasty of Aila, that is Pururava, is being described. And one of the king who appeared in this dynasty is Gadhi. And Gadhi's grandson from the daughter is Parshuram, who is an avatar of Ishvara, and he killed Arjuna. So Arjuna here is Sahasra Arjuna, because Sahasra Arjuna, he has stolen the cow of Jamdagni Rishi, father of Parshuram. So this is Rama. So Parshuram is called also Rama. And he killed him. That's how Parashuram started killing Kshatriyas. So that will be, that story will be coming here in this chapter. So that is what 15th chapter is. Ayor Vansham Vistritam Uparishtad Vakshyan Prathamam Shrutayu Prabhridinam Shannam Vanshan Shankshiptan Aha Shrutayu Riti. So the dynasty coming from Ayu, which is the who is the eldest son of Pururava, says this will be described in detail later on. So first he describes the dynasty coming from the other five, beginning with Shrutayu, in brief Sankshiptanayu. Ekasya iti ekasangya. So this Eka is also a name, otherwise you can think Eka also means one. So in Sanskrit it is very difficult sometimes to figure out if it is a proper noun or just a adjective of somebody. So the word Eka also means one, but here Eka is a proper noun. It's a name of one of them. And then you have to know this. So if the fourth case of Eka will be Ekasmai or Ekaya? Milas. What will be? So think about it.
If it is for particular person, then it's Ekaya. And if it is used as for other things, then it's Ekasmai. We say Sanayi.
So what will be here?
Here it will be Ekaya.
Okay. But in Vishnu Sahasranam, there is a word called Vishwaya. And Vishwa is the name.
Yes.
So it should be Vishwasmai. Why is it Vishwaya?
Vishwa is also the name. Vishwa
yeah.
is also the name.
Yeah, so it should be Vishwaya. Right?
Yeah.
But I think there is a problem. It's one of the... maybe then it is Vishwasmai there.
You can always say Arsa Prayoga.
Yeah, I think it is, instead of Vishwaya, it is Vishwasmai. Okay. So there is a sutra for that also. So, then we have, there is no more commentary. Tataha kusha kushasya api kushambus taniyo vasuhu kushanabhasya chattvaro gadhi rasit kusambujaha. So now from Ajaka, a son was born, his name was Kusha. And from Kusha, there were four sons. And they are Kushambu, Tanaya. Tanaya is another confusing word. Tanaya means son, but Tanaya is a name here. Otherwise you don't get the four, you only get three. So you can think, well, Tanaya is son. No, Tanaya is name, therefore Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur comments Tanayaha Tat Sangya, that Tanaya is his name. And Vasuhu and Kushnabha, these are the four sons, Chattvaro and Gadhi Rasit Kushambuja. And Kushambu, who is the eldest, his son was Gadhi. So there was a famous city called Kaushambi. Is it in Bihar, Kaushambi? Where is Kaushambi? So this was established by this Kaushambu. Famous, once upon a time it was very famous. And this Kusha, there is also a dynasty now, Kaushika. You hear this surname in India, it's still quite popular. Kaushika. So this Kaushikas come from Kusha. So some dynasty, just like Yadu, came long ago. Then the followers are called Yadava till now. But Yadu is son of Yayati. But you don't see the name Yayataya as surname. So some people, some of the famous people, they actually become the giver of the name of the dynasty. Just like Lord Ramachandra is called Raghava, because Raghu was king before him. So Raghavas are there, and there are still Raghavas in India. So like Yadavas, we have Raghavas. So why someone becomes the originator of the dynasty and not their forefathers or not the followers? I don't know the cause. Maybe they were very illustrious, but Kaushika is there, and you have Yadavas, you have Raghavas. But you have Kuru and Kaurava, but not Paurava, because they were also Puru before Kuru.
I searched for Kausambi and it is near Prayag, 56 kilometers near Prayag, and it is located in Yamuna River.
Okay, so that's the Kausambi. So Pururava was also in Pratisthanpur. Pratisthanpur is actually near Prayag also. What is called a Jhusi now. Present it is called Jhusi. You know Jhusi? Magh Mela. So that was originally called Pratisthanpur. That's where the capital of Pururava was. So Kausambi is, he says, 60 kilometers away. So in that area. So they must have made their own palace there in some city. So tasya satyavatim kanyam richiko ayachata dvijaha. So now is the story, Gadhi. So Gadhi comes in the Chandravansa, right? From Pururava dynasty. Now Gadhi is son of Kushambuja, and his daughter was Satyavati. And there was a sage whose name was Richika. So Richika came to Gadhi and he says that, please give me your daughter in marriage. So in the olden days in India, and still in most part, is arranged marriage system. So either father will look for a husband for the daughter, or somebody themselves would come and approach from the boy's father can also approach, but generally it is the girl's father who is more in anxiety to marry the daughter, because it's his responsibility. And the system was that once the girl is of age, then she has to be married. And generally before she gets the period. But after the period, they must marry her within 2 years. That's the Smriti Niyam. So he came to, the sage himself came, approached the king. And king probably was not very inclined to give his daughter to a Brahmana sage. Obviously she is a princess and he is a sage. So she has been brought up in a palace, and parents always want their daughter to be in a nice house where she can lead a comfortable life. So this is their anxiety, that they don't want to give their daughter where she is going to go and suffer. So he was not very inclined to give, but at the same time, they are also afraid of the sages. This was one fear, that what if he curses me? So then, like you know the story of Sabari Muni also, similar. He went to the king and asked for daughters. So he gave some excuse, not refusing but not saying yes. So here also he says, Varam Vishidrusham Matva Gadhir Bhagargavam Abravit. So he understood that this vara, this bridegroom, is Visadrisham. Means he is not a match for my daughter. So match is between equals. So if there was another king, another young man, prince, then it is proper. But now this is coming sage. We don't know how old he was, and obviously he doesn't have a penny in his pocket. Because these sages, they have nothing to do with money. Most they may have some disciples, they teach them. But they were not having wealth. Their wealth was knowledge, vidyadhanam, not the other dhanam, not godhan, gajadhan, vajidhan, different types of wealth. So they did not have that. Maybe he had some cows that he had. As you know, the problem came because of that. So he told to this sage Bhargava, Bhargava again because coming in the Bhrigu dynasty, that look, I will give my daughter to you, but here is the condition. Ektaha Sham Karnanam Hayanam Chandravarchasam Sahasram Diyatam Shulkam Kanyaya Kushikavayam. He says, look, my dear sage, we are Kushikas. Means I am born in the Kusha dynasty. Don't think I am just some Tom, Dick and Harry guy. So I have some lineage, I have some name, fame, and you want my daughter, so you have to pay some price. So generally, asking for price for daughter, that is considered as sinful. You don't sell your daughter for money. But he was doing this just to send him off. He was not expecting that this guy will come up with such a thing. So he says, if you can give me 1,000 horses. And what kind of horses? They should be white in color and 1 year black. But I give you the option that ear can be left or right, that's all right. I'm not being specific that it must be the left ear or right ear, but one of the ear has to be black and rest of the body white.
But he was not afraid to ask the brahmana like this?
Afraid he doesn't want to marry his daughter.
Yeah, but then he might just curse him.
Why? Why should he? He's not saying no.
He's saying no, okay.
And he has no reason to curse. He says, look, we are Kushikas. And you gave me. And why he's asking? Because I want to do some yajna. These are the horses which are used for Ashwamedh yajna. So if you can get me that, you can have my daughter. So he thought that this fellow can never get even one horse like this. 1,000 is impossible. Even one is difficult. So his trick was that he will say, okay, thank you very much. I'll find some other girl. I will become old, but I will never be able to do this. But he was determined. So where there is a will, there is a way. Right? That's what they say. So he found a way. Especially if you want a wife. You can cross the mountains, they say. You can cross the seas for the sake of wife. So he did that. So when he was told this, Iti yukta stan matam gyatva Gatah sa varunantikam. So the sage was also not foolish. So when he was told like this, he understood what he is trying to do. Right? So therefore he says that iti yukta, when he was told like this, tan matam gyatva. So he understood what is his intention, that he is just trying to avoid. So he says, chalo bachchu dekhte hain tere ko. You are trying to be smart, I will outsmart you. So what did he do? He went to Varuna. So it is understood historically that horses came from the west. Right? So Varuna is the in charge of the western direction, therefore he has horses. So he went to Varuna and he says, please give me 1,000 horses. And Varuna says, no problem. So he got these 1,000 horses as required by the king. And now he had no choice but to give his daughter to the sage. So aniya dattva tan ashwan upayeme varananam. So he came and he gave the horses, and in exchange he got the beautiful wife, Varanana. Varanana means who has a most beautiful face. So any comment on this? Gadhe putro Vishwamitro Brahmarshi Abhut iti uttaradhyaye vakshate. So Gadhi's son was Vishwamitra, daughter is Satyavati, son was born later on. So the story of Vishwamitra, he says, will come in the next chapter, chapter 16. So that is also an interesting story. And tasya kanya vansha prasange naiva Parshuram avataram vaksham. So with the intention to describe the descent of Bhagavan Parshuram, and because he wants to talk about Parshuram, therefore he mentions the story of the sage Rishik, because Parshuram was born from Satyavati. So prathamam Rishik Rishi charitam ahai tasyaiti. So therefore he speaks about the sage Rishika. Kushika iti kushasya vansa vayam kshatriya api sarvato api kulina iti bhava. So when he says Kushika Vayam, so if somebody says that we are so and so, right? That we are Brahmanas from Konkan. Right? So if he says I am a Konkani Brahmana, or Brahmani means I am somebody. Don't think of me just an ordinary person. So when he said Kushika Vayam, he is using plural. He did not say Kushika Aham. Says Kushika Vayam. So means he is being very self-respectful. So what is the intention? That we are Kshatriyas and not ordinary Kshatriyas. We are Sarvato Api Kulina. We are the best of Kshatriyas. Kulina means born in a nice, wonderful family, like they call as Abhijat, right? In Bengal, they use the word Abhijat. So Abhijat means born in a good family. So that is also the word Kulina. And he says Sarvato Api Kulina. So Sarvato Api Kulina means that we are better than anyone else. So don't think that I am going to give my daughter to you just like that. You have to prove to me that you are qualified. So this was many times done in the past in India, when great kings, they had daughter, they want to marry their daughter, then they want to make sure that one who will marry my daughter is qualified, and they will put some condition. Right? So like for Bhagavan Ram, we saw that whoever can break the bow of Shiva, then can marry. For Draupadi, whoever can shoot the eye of the fish, not the bull's eye, the fish eye, so can have Draupadi. Then we had that, was the wife of Krishna, where he has to control the 7 bulls. No. Probably.
Nagjiti.
Yeah, Nagjiti, right. You're right, thank you. Yeah, Nagjiti. So there are many times there were conditions like that. Anyone who can do that. So generally they were related with their Kshatriya character. Means they are good in shooting, fighting, physical strength. Right? So that, so he also put a condition like this. Here it was not some physical strength, he wants to, he just wanted to send him away basically. So Dakshin Vamayor Madhye Ektaha Shyama Karno Yesham Tesham. So he says Ektaha Shyam Karna Nam means any one of the 2 ears, left or right, doesn't matter, it should be Shyama, black in color. Then I will marry my daughter. So he fulfilled and he was married. So now he is living with Satyavati, the sage Ruchik, and he was a great sage. And Gadhi did not have a son. He only had a daughter, daughter got married. So Gadhi's wife, she thought that I can ask my son-in-law, he is a sage, that he can perform some yajna or something so that I can have a son. So this is being therefore described here. Sa rishi prarthita patnya swashruva cha patya kamyaya shrapyatva bhair mantrais charum snatum gato muni. So probably he was visiting the family of his wife, or they were visiting him, but both of them, his wife and wife's mother, mother-in-law, they both approached sage Ruchika that please bless us to have sons. So his wife also wanted a son, and wife's mother also wanted a son. So what Ruchika did, that he made a charu. So charu is some kind of laddu, you can think. He made 2 laddus and he chanted mantras. So one of the laddu he empowered with Brahma Tej, and the other he empowered with Kshatriya Tejas, so that he will give one to his wife with the Brahma Tejas, so that she will have a Brahmana son, and to the mother-in-law, because they are Kshatriyas, so he will get, she will have a Kshatriya child. So that's what is said here. That Sarishi Prarthita Patnya Swashriya Chai Patya Kamyaya. That he was begged by his wife and his mother-in-law for the desire to have a son. And Shrapiyatvo Bhayair Mantrais Charum Snatum Gatomuni. So then he made a charu, and with 2 different mantras, and after he gave it to them, then he went to the river, maybe noon time, to take a dip and chant his Gayatri, do his Sandhya Vandana. So in between the problem happened. तावत् सत्यवती मात्रा स्वचरुं याचिता सती श्रेष्ठं मत्वा तया आयच्छन् मात्रे मातृ अदत् स्वयं. सो सत्यवती'स मदर, शी वॉज क्लेवर. शी थॉट दैट दिस सेज हैज गिवन अस टू सेपरेट चरुज एंड he must be favoring his wife more than me, so that his wife will have a better son than me. So she asked her daughter that let's exchange. You give your laddu to me and take mine, because she is thinking that her laddu must be having more power than my laddu. So obviously mother is asking, the daughter cannot say no. Although daughter also must be thinking, why you want to do that? But she could not say no. So therefore she gave her share to the mother and Matur Adat Swayam. And the one from the mother, Shrestham Matva Taya Ayachan Matre. So and took her, and they both ate it. So this created problem. So ubhayir mantrai brahmai kshatraischa. So Vishnu Chakrati comments that this ubhay mantrai, both mantras means the mantra of brahmana and क्षत्र. सो ब्राह्मी मंत्रै पत्नी चरुम दत्वा स्वश्रय तु क्षत्रै मंत्रै. सो ही गेव द चरु टू हिज वाइफ विच हैड द पावर ऑफ द ब्रह्म तेजस एंड चरु टू हिज मदर इन लॉ विच हैज द पावर ऑफ क्षत्रिय क्षत्र तेजस. नाउ दे एक्सचेंज्ड इट. So then the sage returned after taking his dip in the river and chanting. When he came back, by the yogic power, he understood that something is out of place. So therefore he says, Tadvigyaya muni praha patnim kashtam akarashihi ghoro dandadhara putro bhrata te brahma vittama. So after knowing this, the sage told to his wife that you have acted wrongly. You should not have done this. And the wife said, why, what is wrong? Says, because you do not understand, I made these two charus so that you will have a brahmana boy and she will have a kshatriya boy. So now you changed it. So what is the situation? She will have a son who will be the knower of the Vedas, Brahma Vittama. And you will have a son who will be Ghora, Dandadhara, who will be the wielder of weapon, who will be the chastiser, and he will be harsh, Kshatriya. Ghora here means not terrible, but in the sense he will not be mild, Brahmana looking, but he will be very strong Rajasic type. So this is what you have done. Okay, what can I do now? So yavat snatva munir nagata stavadeva satvatyam bhratrishnehadhikyat tasyascharum shreshtam matva aniya matra yachita satyavati matre स्वचरुम ब्रह्मंत्राभिमंत्रितम अयच्छन. सो बिफोर द सेज रिटर्न बैक आफ्टर टेकिंग द डिप, सत्यवती द मदर ऑफ सत्यवती थॉट दैट द सेज ऋचिक मस्ट हैव मोर अफेक्शन फॉर हिज वाइफ माई डॉटर सत्यवती एंड देयरफॉर हर चरु इज बेटर देन माइन एंड Thinking like this, he begged the daughter to give it to her. So Satyavati Matre Svacharum Brahma Mantra Abhimantritam Yach. So Satyavati gave the charu, this laddu, to the mother, which had the power of Brahma Teja. And Matus Charu Kshatram Abhimantritam Swayam Adat Bhakshitvati, and she herself ate the other one. So when he came, he understood. So kashtam jugupshitam dandadharam kshatriya bhavishyati. So he said that your son is going to be in dandadhara. Jugupshitam means not very likable, means he is not going to do the brahmana activities. And your brother, he will be brahmavittama. He will be a brahmana. So such a Vishwamitra iti uttaradhyaye vakshate. So he is the one who was born as Vishwamitra. So this will be described in the next chapter. Prasadita satyavatya maivam bhud bhargavah athatarhi bhavet potro jamadagnis tato bhavat. So when the wife heard this, then she pleaded to the husband that, please, please, let it not be like this. So then the sage, he said that, I can postpone it. That's what I can do. So that instead of your son being Dandadhara, chastiser, ruler, it is your grandson who will be like that. So therefore, Satyavati gave birth to Sage Jamadagni. And then Jamadagni's son was born as Parshuram, who created havoc, killing Kshatriyas. So this is an interesting story. So any questions on this? So interesting, some research can be done in genetics like this. How you can postpone? Yes.
I have a question about the Ganga pastime.
Yes, sir.
So the water of the Ganga that's flowing now, is our belief that it is coming from Shivji's Gata then, even today? Or?
Yes. That's the belief. Still believe that it is Charanamrita of Vishnu. Actually, people, that's how now people don't believe it, but in the olden days, people had so much Shraddha. You cannot even believe that people had such Shraddha. Forget about having that Shraddha. They had Shraddha like that. Especially in the olden days when it was, people were not traveling like now, it is easy. Anyone can go and take a dip in Ganga. But for village people it was not easy to go. There were no means of traveling. You have to just walk. So only on very some special occasions, once in a while, they will go with bullock carts and there were no arrangements. Now if you go, you can go to Haridwar or Rishikesh and so many places there, everywhere there are 5-star hotels. You can stay without any problem. Olden days there was nothing, it was all forest. So even going there, you have to carry your food and everything, your beddings, where you will sleep. So it was troublesome to go. But they had so much faith. One person will go and bring some bottle of Ganga Jal and then the whole village will be queuing to get one drop of that. Now you can buy Ganga Jal bottles. I think somebody was bottling it and selling. So So now people are drinking it like any other water. They don't have any faith in it, that it is Gangajal. But in the olden days, the kings, some kings, they used to travel to Europe by ship. They will carry big, big drums full of Ganga water, because they will not drink any other water. So they will go to Germany, and some of these hotels, they will camp there. They will have their arrangement. This Vrajeshwara was telling me that many times he bought some of these old things, because he deals in this old artifacts. So he will go to Jaipur, and he was telling me these stories. So that was the type of Shraddha they had. There was once I was traveling in the Himalaya region, and we went to Gangotri, and the helicopter came there, and we just were curious. I was with this Gurukula boys, so we went there, and it was an army helicopter. So I was talking, he says that he comes every day, takes Ganga water for the President of India. Shankar Dayal Sharma was the president. So he says he drinks Ganga water, and it comes right from the source. So those were olden days. Now, Haji.
Is this Satyavati having any connection with the this Bhishma's mother Satyavati, or just namesake?
No, there is no connection. This is a different Satyavati.
Hari Bol, Babaji.
Hari Bol.
I'm just wondering, at the beginning of the story, why the sage would search for a wife the king's daughter. Isn't it surprising that a sage is first looking for a wife?
Maybe no, because you think that sage means only renounced person. So if you see the sages in India, most of them were not renounced, they were married people. You can see Vasishtha, Atri, Chavan, Kashyap. They're all sages, but they all had wives. So this is what Krishna is also, if you read Bhagavad Gita, he's not so much talking about sannyas type of sage. Sannyasam karmana nyasam. So he says that tayostu karma sannyasat karma yoga visheshyate. So says that both are good, Sreyasam Ubho, but between the two, he says that Karma Yoga is better than Karma Sannyas. So this is more practical. So most sages were like that. And obviously, if you want a wife, you choose, just like if you want to have a husband, you want to have a qualified husband. You don't want to marry anybody and anyone like that. So he thought that this girl is suitable for me. See, he's of good character, and she did prove to be a good wife. Doesn't matter if it is born in a Kshatriya family. So also there were Anulom and Pratilom marriage. So Anulom means that the Brahmanas can marry the lower three daughters. Kshatriya can marry the other two. The other one is called Pratilom. That is the one which is not recommended. So this was also it was allowed.
Babaji. You had last time one of the classes you had explained that these Vanshajas are described because out of the 10 criteria, one criteria is describing these vanshajas, and also that one can identify with any of these personalities. But many of these people who are described are not devotees also. So then, like identifying means in what sense?
So how many are devotees in India? Tell me.
They are very less.
So if they are less and they are not devotees, it is not good that they can identify with some sage, it will not benefit them. What do you think?
Yes.
And even if you are a devotee, what is wrong in identifying? You will still think, I come in this great lineage. Just because you become devotee doesn't mean that you have become like some Vaikuntha person now. You still need some good identity so that you can fix your mind. It still helps. Okay.
Yes. Thank you.